Match game 74, production number 0210. Take one. Get ready to match the stars. Jack Carter. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Chris Stewart. Richard Dawson. And Kay Stevens. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. You have no idea what a surprise it is to walk out here and expecting to find something this size to find something that size. I didn't know this thing telescoped. Who did this?
Nixon.
Dickie
Nixon.
Dawson. Oh, thank you. Dickie Dawson. Dickie Dawson is a bad guy. He did it.
Hello there.
We just fed it
a little and it nourished it and it went.
Now that you got your fairy wand, what are you going to make into us?
No.
Listen, I forgot to mention your appearance in Canada.
Oh, yes, I'm going to Toronto, Canada.
Toronto?
To Ontario Place, which is the Disney World of Canada. And I'll be there May 28th for a concert, and I'm very excited about that.
Okay, we're excited
Ontario
for
Place, you must all come.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, let's say hello to our two players, Shirley Kilgore and C.B. Farnsworth. Shirley's the current champ with $7,350. He's won five games. We started the game last time we were together, and he scored twice in his first half of the round, and we have yet to get to your first round question, but we'll do that right after we do a little business with you, friends, so stick around. Now, we're ready to carry on here, something we started yesterday. We'll finish round one by reading this question for Shirley Kilgore. Everybody participates. I've got good news and bad news, folks.
Yeah.
First, the bad news. A giant meteor is speeding toward the Earth. And the good news, it's headed right for blank.
Oh, that's easy. That's easy.
Oh, did you hear that, Shirley? Good news and bad news. First, the bad news. A giant meteor is speeding toward the Earth. The good news, it's headed right for blank. Everybody ready over there? Charles, did you think of one?
What are we going to do with Charles?
I don't know. I just...
Do you suppose we could practice?
We put him in the back of the
room.
Class already.
Yes. No, I was going to put NBC, but I couldn't.
Oh, you couldn't. All right. Now, Shirley, good news and bad news. First, the bad news. A giant meteor is speeding toward the Earth. The good news, it's headed right for blank.
Washington.
Washington. I think she has a point there.
I think she's made a very wise choice, Ollie.
What did you say?
It's a new game show called Beat the Cup. I'll put Washington, too.
Washington, D.C.
Yes? Does she mean Washington State?
No. D.C. Darn
D.C.
crowded.
I didn't ask you, dear.
Democrats.
I asked the lady over there.
Oh, I certainly hope so.
I said Washington.
That's what she said, Washington. Charles, what did you say?
Well, I think we should stand behind the country in a time of turmoil. I really do.
Yeah.
Because enough jokes have been made, so here's another one.
How do you feel about this, Trish?
Well, I was going to say Washington and decided against it. And I thought the one person who could handle it was Santa.
Santa! The bad news is headed
Trish,
right
get
for
your
Santa.
Act together.
Get out.
A girl who would wear a see-through blouse like you're wearing would say Santa Claus? The meteor is headed for Santa Claus?
I didn't know.
What did you say? Back down.
Well, obviously, it would have to be good news to head for Washington. I was a little more specific. I said,
no.
The White House. That's in Washington.
The
Come on, click it up.
No, sorry
all right,
about that.
I'm not moving till I get the tape. Don't tell me they're erased. Isn't that in Washington?
That's where it is.
Now it's a restaurant.
White House. But her answer was Washington. We have to be a little more specific. Kay, what did you
say? Just a second.
Well, Washington. I was thinking of pollution. About polluted lakes. This is where I know the most polluted waters are, in Cleveland. And I thought, we could start all over. Well, I tried.
Lake Erie.
Lake Erie, yeah.
Okay, so at the end of round one, the score is 3-2 in favor of the champ. We go to round two and ask CB to make a selection.
B.
Okay. Now, let's see. Last time out, you matched Jack and Brett. The two of you will lay out, and the rest of you will write. The farmer said...
That'll be enough of that.
The farmer said... My new scarecrow is so scary that when my wife saw it, she blanked.
She what?
When my wife saw it, she blanked. That's a scary scarecrow. You hear that? Okay. Charles, you're the first one finished.
No, he's
and
yes,
study
he
well about time.
Been writing a novel while I've been
No, Charles is the first one.
No, I wish C.B. Farnsworth became a famous producer because I would love to be his secretary so you could say every morning, good morning, C.B. Farnsworth Productions.
All right, C.B. Farnsworth. The farmer said, my new scarecrow is so scary that when my wife saw it, she blanked.
Fainted.
Yes, the right audience. The audience thinks that's okay, Charles.
On the side of the law.
Fainted. Right on for you, CB. How about it, Trish?
Fainted?
There's two. All right.
I hope this won't mean a moving violation, CB. I said scream.
Scream.
Just a little humor. You know how we actors are.
What did you say, Kay?
Both in trouble, because I said scream.
Two screams and two faints.
Two in Toronto.
I screamed.
Two and two. All right, 4-3 the score in the middle of our second and final round, and we'll pick up with you right after we pick up on a little money here. Here we go. You ready? Okay, now the score is 4-3. You must match one celebrity to stay in the game. Two, however, will win your sixth game. The bullfighter said,
this is the meanest bull in all of Spain. He has blank on his horns.
That's I think you've offended a lot of our Latin friends. Could
it's
I hear
Freddy
that
Lopez
in English?
The bullfighter said, this is the meanest bull in all of Spain. He has blank on his horns.
I think there's more Hungarian in that than Spanish, actually.
Now, who's playing here? Trish, Richard, and Kay, just the lower tier. Okay. All set over there. So, Shirley, it's up to you.
Come on, Shirley, keep away.
Bullfighter said this is the meanest bull in all of Spain. He has blank on his horns.
Spurs.
You got a groan from the audience. And they're going to throw you to the bulls, too, I think. Spurs was the answer she gave.
That jingle jangle, baby.
Trish?
Spurs was just about as bad as mine. Blood.
Sure. That would be an indication that he's the meanest bull in all of Spain.
Good. Very rare. Typo.
Blood. Okay. You've got to match Kay Stevens to stay in the game. Kay?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Trini Lopez.
Oh, blood on the side.
Spurs!
Stevens in the game. Congratulations. There's $100 for you. Well, we've really gotten to know Shirley Kilgore very well. She's been here a long, long time. She's won five games and a total of $7,350. It's been a pleasure meeting you.
It's been a great pleasure.
Goodbye, Shirley.
Bye-bye, Shirley.
Gene.
Yes, sir?
Make him show you his license. Something.
He's got one, I'm sure of that. You ready, CB?
I guess so.
You're going to have a go at over $5,000 here now, you know, and you know how it goes, don't you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Casey Blank.
Oh.
Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. Then if you match the next one, it's $250 for you. If you match the bottom one, it's $100. Which celebrities would you like to call on for a little assist?
Richard.
Well, am I glad you came to me first. Casey Jones.
Casey Jones. Okay, there's one.
Okay.
Brett.
How about Casey at the Bat?
Casey at the Bat. Famous poem
in
American folklore.
Well, there was an older crowd here that day, so be careful.
Casey Jones, Casey at the Bat. The only last one I know left is Casey Stengel.
Yeah.
Okay. So you've got Casey Stengel, Casey at the Bat, and Casey Jones. CB, you may choose one of those or give us one of your own, but now we have to call for an answer. What do you want to do?
Casey Jones.
Casey Jones. Okay. We are looking for Casey Jones. Where are you, Casey Jones? Are you under the $100 response? Casey at the Bat is there. That's the one that Brett gave you. Okay. Casey Jones, the one he's looking for. Here is the $250 response. Casey Stengel. Well, so
that's
far, you got two out
got
of three.
It.
That may be a good sign, CB.
Oh, yeah, get it.
Here is the $500 response.
Yeah!
Casey Jones.
Yeah!
Congratulations.
Well done.
Congratulations.
Let's get the biggie.
Did he hurt you?
CB.
Did he hurt you? Here,
count all your fingers.
Check it out. It'll be better now.
Is that some kind of a joke?
Yeah.
I remember him now, Gene.
Oh, my.
Okay. Well, he's very excited and he's very happy. How do you feel?
Great.
Good. Now, you've got the $500. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. To collect, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Has to be exact. Choose one now.
Try Richard again.
You go for the other hand if we win, right?
Okay, he's ready to write. Here is the $5,000 question. Simple blank. Simple blank. He's finished. Now, CB, it's up to you to come up with an answer you think will match Richard over there. Simple blank.
Simon.
Simon. Simple Simon, eh?
Check your arm.
We didn't quite get the shot. Would you do it again?
I'll save any embarrassment.
All right, Frisco.
Well, CB, I have good news and bad news. The bad news is my car won't start up there. Good news is I have Simon.
Yeah!
Terrific. Okay. Your wife here? Where?
On third row back. Eugene.
Oh, yeah. Hello there. Good one. Oh, we're very happy for you. You've got $5,600. Do you have any plans for the money, or didn't you plan to win any money tonight?
We can pay the doctor now. We get our baby.
Well, that's right.
Shipping a couple of bucks to repair my hand, if you don't.
Why doesn't he bribe a civilian?
All right, you're going to play another game, CB, and meet another challenger right now. Here comes Karen Anderson. You know, CB?
Hi.
How's Karen Anderson?
Just fine, thank you.
He's very excited.
And I'm so happy for him. It's fantastic.
Good. Where are you from, Karen?
Well, I'm originally from Wolf Point, Montana, would you believe? And now we're living in Claremont. And I have a husband who just recently was promoted to sergeant, police sergeant. And I have...
That's your
it's a raid. The whole show's a raid.
Greg.
You're just the lowest on the ladder, huh? Her husband's a sergeant.
He'll get you.
I'm sergeant. I have to come back to Los Angeles.
And
I have two wonderful children.
Okay. All right. Good luck to both players. We'll get back to them after we do a little business with you. Here we go.
Today's consolation prize is our Lava Life, the exotic light of a million moving shapes with the soothing glow that intrigues and entertains from Lava Simplex Corporation, Chicago. And an assortment from the Roos family of quality floor care products, including Clean and Wax, cleans, waxes, and buffs to that rich, warm glow of Paste Wax Beauty. And a supply of Golden Dip. Quality meat, seafood, and chicken deserve this fine breading, not leftover crumbs. You can bake or fry with Golden Dip. In the merry, merry month of May, complete the day by watching Match Game 74 as it blanks ahead in 1 minute.
All right, here we go. I'll push a button and reveal two questions and ask Karen, our challenger, to make a selection.
A.
A. You just made up your mind about that, right? Okay. Gertrude said to Harvey, "It was nice when you said my mother reminded you of a movie star, but it was rotten to say it was blank." Did you hear that, Karen? Gertrude said to Harvey, "It was nice when you said my mother reminded you of a movie star, but it was rotten to say it was blank." All right, the lower tier is ready, upper tier.
Upper tier, ready.
Anytime.
I drew the cup.
It does look like him a little bit. A little gift from Jack Carter there for you, CB. Ready? Okay, here we go. Karen Anderson. Gertrude said to Harvey, "It was nice when you said my mother reminded you of a movie star, but it was rotten to say it was..."
Frankenstein.
Frankenstein. That's a very original answer. Very clever answer, I think. Jack, what do you say?
Well, when Harvey started sending Gertrude's mother Gainsburgers, he knew he was in trouble because she reminded him of Lassie.
Lassie. All right, Brett.
Oh, golly, I went for every old character lady that ever lived, including Margaret Hamilton, Ethel Griffiths. Funny, I ended up with Marjorie May.
Marjorie May. Charles?
I went back to the dogs.
Lassie.
Lassie, go home and stay there.
My generation would have said Rin Tin Tin. What, are your
Not
what does your generation say?
What do you mean, your generation? Mine said Lassie.
Lassie,
too.
Yeah. That seems to be the answer. All right, Richard. Have you got the popular favorite?
I do. Lassie.
Lassie is the popular favorite.
I played the lead in it.
Yes.
I don't want to discuss it. I said Rin Tin Tin.
Okay. All right. I take it all back.
There was nothing wrong with silent movies.
Okay.
Silent people.
All right. Where are we? We got this for you, CB. You ready?
Yes, so.
Ready okay. When you are, CB.
Oh, yes. Dr. Welby said, you remember Dr. Welby?
Kidding?
He said, "Consuela, why don't you come over for dinner tonight? I'm making my specialty, a meatloaf in the shape of a blank." You know, Consuela on the show, he said to her, "Why don't you come over to dinner tonight? I'm making my specialty, a meatloaf in the shape of a blank." Dr. Welby said that.
Bottom row is finished now.
Bottom row is finished. All right, they're all set.
Out to lunch.
Okay.
I'm getting very sleepy.
Charles, please.
I know that Marcus Welby is on another network, but you could write a little faster. All right, CB. Dr. Welby said, "Consuela, why don't you come over for dinner tonight? I'm making my specialty a meatloaf in the shape of a..."
Heart.
Heart.
Oh. I was going to say that because that's what happened to Black Killer. When he dies, you drive a spare rib through his heart.
Yes. Well,
but
what did you say?
It's in the shape of a hospital.
In a shape of a hospital.
A building made of chicken
fat. That must have been some big meatloaf, I say.
No, it was a small building.
Brett?
You must admit he's the biggest Monday morning quarterback in the business. Right?
Right.
Everybody knows what a Monday morning quarterback is, right? The person... Oh, well, I can't go into it. Stethoscope.
Stethoscope is good. Right, Charles?
I want to check that spelling.
S-T-F-E.
Consuela, I said tamale.
Tamale. A meatloaf in the shape of a tamale? 40 lashes for you.
I thought it was cute.
Yeah.
Wrong.
What do you say, Trish?
Well, I was going to say heart, too, but he's a GP, and they don't do heart surgery, so I said bladder.
That's a good one. That takes care of refreshments, too.
Okay.
Bladder?
Richard, what are you offering?
Makes me look like a piker. I said an appendix.
Well, we've covered the whole body.
All right.
I got the goodie.
You have?
I got the goodie.
I'll bet you do.
This is what I want.
Right.
Shape of liver.
Liver. Okay. So at the end of round one, we have no score, and round two will be next. But first, we've got to do a little business. This is it. Here we are. And we got to go. So round two coming up next time we get together, all right?
Okay.
All right. Karen and CB. Listen, you were all splendid. I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Yes.
And you especially. We'll look forward to seeing you again sometime here soon.
Thank you.
And you will all look forward to seeing Trish Stewart on CBS, on daytime television. She precedes us by several hours, depending on where you live in the country.
Some heavy breathing.
Yes. Anything else?
No, I'll be in Las Vegas under the name of Robert Goulet.
All right.
Oh, I'm going to be in Florida on Father's
You're
Day.
You're going to be in Florida on Father's Day.
Can you find me a father?
I'll be at the Food Giant Thursday.
And will Brett Summers' nurse please report to the backstage area?
Okay. I think that about wraps it up, folks. We hope you'll be able to join us next time for more fun and hilarity on Match Game 74 when we will have this assortment of ding-a-lings.
Greg Morris, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ann Mira, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder.
Dean Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Bye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.